morning to all. Welcome to Adarsh Vidyalaya Max online classes. Today we are going to continue the topic, same topic, geometric progression. We are solving problem in exercise 2.7, and now we are going to discuss in that thinking corner. There are three questions given, so let us see one by one. The first question is, split the number 64 into three parts such that they will form a GP. It means if you divide into 3, okay, so they will form a GP. Like that we are going to arrange. So better we find the prime factor of the number 64. It can be divisible by 2, right? So 2 table, 32, again 2, 16, again 2, 8, again 2, 4, and this 4 can be written as 2 into 2, okay. So I am going to write this as 2, comma, next 2 square comma remaining 1 2 3, so 2 cube, it will form a GP. Let's verify it. First term of the GP is 2, second term 2 square means 4 and 2 cube means 8, okay, they will form a GP. If you find their common ratio, R is equal to 2 square 4, 4 by 2 means 2, understand? And third term divided by second term, third term is 2 cube 8, 8 by 4 gives 2, so they will form a GP, okay. This is very easy question. Next, if A, B, C are in GP, then 2A, 2B and 2C are in dash, okay. If we multiply it by a non-zero constant, they said clearly these three terms are in GP. Okay, if you multiply it by a non-zero constant by that term, what do we get? They are also in a GP. Okay, this is a result, important result. So if you multiply it or divided by a non-zero constant, then we get the resultant sequence is also a GP. Okay, right. So it is R in GP. Okay, next question. If 3 comma x comma 6.75 are in GP, then what is the value of x? You know that their common ratios must be same. So common ratios in the sense T2 divided by T1 is equal to T3 divided by T2. Okay, what is T2? That is x by T1 is 3 is equal to, and T3 is 6.75 divided by T2 is x. This x into x, x square. So x square equal to 3 into 6.75. After cross multiplication, we get x square is equal to 3 into 6.75. So what is the product? 6.75. 675 into 3. If you multiply 5, remaining 1. 3 sevens are 21, 22. Remaining 2. 3 6 are 18, 20. 2025. So it can be written as, actually after decimal two places. So here 20.25. X square is equal to 20.25. So what is the value of x? If x square equal to 20.25 means the value of x is equal to square root of 20.25, we can get 4.5. So the value of x is equal to 4.5. okay, next, three non-zero numbers A, B and C are in GP, then, so in arithmetic progression you have learnt T2 minus T1 is equal to T3 minus T2. After that you will get 2B equal to A plus C for AP. This result for AP, if you prove this result, you can say the terms are in AP. Like here you can write B by A equal to C by B. What it is? T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T2. So if you do cross multiplication, what do we get? B square equal to AC. So if you show B square equal to AC, you can say A, B, C are in GP. This is also one of the general result. It is using to prove some result, okay. While solving, we need 3 consecutive terms, 4 consecutive terms. At that time, we can take 3 consecutive terms of GP, 3 consecutive terms. Three consecutive terms of GP or A by R, comma A and AR. We can take like this. If four consecutive terms means A by R cube, comma A by R, comma AR, comma AR cube. Like this you can take, okay? So if you need to find the three consecutive terms of the GP, you can take these three, A by R, A and AR. So four consecutive terms means you can take these four values, A by R cube, A by R, AR and AR cube, okay? Right, let's move to the problems in exercise 2.7. Exercise 2.7, question number 9. Already we discussed three consecutive terms of a GP, B, A by R, A, comma AR. We can take these three for consecutive terms of a GP, okay? So first condition, product of three consecutive terms is 27. Product of three consecutive terms. So first, using the first condition, product A by R into A into AR is equal to 27, their products. You can cancel this and this. A into A into A will get A cube is equal to 27. A cube is equal to 27 means A is equal to 3. It means 3 cube is equal to 27, so that we get A equal to 3. Okay, let's move to the second condition. Sum of the product of two terms is R 57 by 2. For example, product of this and this, A by R into A plus second term and third term, A into AR plus third term and first term. So what do we get? AR into A by R, like this, which is equal to 57 by 2, they said clearly, okay? So A by R into A first or second condition, A by R into A plus A into AR plus AR into A by R, which is equal to 57 by 2. Now A into A will get A square by R plus A into A, A square R plus, this can be cancelled, so we'll get A square, which is equal to 57 by 2. Now we can take that common factor A square out. So what do we get? If you take that common factor out, means we'll get 1 by R plus 1, which is equal to 57 by 2. We can substitute the value of A here. So A is equal to 3. So A square means 9 of, here I am going to find the LCM. Here R by 1, here 1 by 1. So LCM of these three terms is R. So 1, if you multiply it by R, you can get R. So numerator is also multiplied by R. So we'll get R square plus, here you want to multiply it by R, numerator is also multiplied by R, which is equal to 57 by 2. Next, this is in multiplication, left hand side. If you take this right answer, it becomes division. So we can write it as a ascending order. So 1 plus R square divided by R, which is equal to 57 by this 9 into 2, 18. 9 into 2, 18. We can simplify them by using 3 table. So 3 table means how many times? 6 times. Here, 1 time, 9 times. 19 by 6. So next, do cross multiplication. So 6 into 1, 6 plus 6 into R, 6R plus 6R square, which is equal to 19R. Which is equal to 19R. So now, 6R square, if you take this 19R left hand side, it becomes minus 19R plus 6R plus 6, which is equal to 0. Okay. So now 19R plus, it means minus 19r plus 6r gives 6r square minus 13r plus 6 is equal to 0. Okay, so we get a quadratic equation of variable r. Quadratic equation of variable r. So now I am going to find the values of r. Values of r, how can we find it? By using factorization method. Like this, if the leading coefficient is except 1, this can be multiplied by the constant term. I told you by method. First, we multiplied by the leading coefficient. So 6 into 6 is 36 and this minus 13. Okay, so first we multiplied the leading coefficient by the constant term, 6 into 6 is 36 plus sign, here minus 13. So if you multiply it by 9 into 4 36, 9 plus 4 is 13, but here minus sign is there. So both are negative. So minus into minus plus, when we add them, we assign the minus sign and add together. So minus 13, okay. Actually, I multiplied by 6, you know, so I want to divide by. That's why I said by method. First we multiplied, next we divide. Don't forget it. We should divide by the same leading coefficient 6, okay. So this can be cancelled. So 3 table means 2 times, here 3 times. Here 2 table means 2 times, 3 times. Understand? So either you can write it factor form or directly you can write the value of r. How can we write it? Actually, variable is 3 by 2, r minus 3 by 2 into this one, r minus 2 by 3, which is equal to 0. Am I right? So these two are the factors. So what are the values of r? So first equate to 0, r minus 3 by 2 equal to 0, we'll get r is equal to 3 by 2. And second, r minus 2 by 3 equal to 0, r is equal to 2 by 3. Okay, so the value of r are 3 by 2 and 2 by 3. Okay, next we are going to find the three consecutive terms. What are they? A by r, comma a and ar. Okay, these three are the consecutive terms. First we assign the value of a and r, we can get the three consecutive terms. Actually we found the value of a equal to 3 and r has two values. What are they? 3 by 2 and 2 by 3. So that I divided into two cases. First case, a equal to 3, r equal to 3 by 2. Second case, a equal to 3, r is equal to 2 by 3. Okay, let us substitute their values. So first a by r, what is a? 3 by r is equal to 3 by 2. It is in fraction, so that we can write it reciprocal form. So reciprocal of 3 by 2 is 2 by 3, comma this one a, 3. Next a into r, 3 into 3 by 2. If you simplify, you can get this will be cancelled, 2 comma 3 comma 3 into 3, 9 by 2. This is first one. Okay, next a equal to 3, but r is equal to 2 by 3 means 3 into reciprocal of 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. Next 3, next one 3 into 2 by 3. Okay, so 3 into 3, 9 by 2 comma 3, this will be cancelled, we will get 2. So 2 comma 3 comma 9 by 2 are the required three consecutive terms of this GP. I hope you understand. Similar problem is given in example. Okay, try to solve that. Thank you. Next, exercise 2.7, question number 12. And next video, I'll teach you question number 10 and 11. Okay, so let us solve the problem number 12. Given A, B, C are three consecutive terms of an AP, as well as X, Y, Z are three consecutive terms of a GP. Okay, we are going to prove X power B minus C into Y power C minus A into Z power A minus B, which is equal to 1. If you take LHS, you are going to show that which is equal to 1. Okay, so A, B, C are in AP means, you know that the general form of AP, that is A comma a plus b comma a plus 2d comma and so on. Okay, this is first term, so that I have taken a. If the second term b equal to a plus d and third term can be written as a plus 2d, okay. If it is the first term of AP, I take a. B is the second term, means instead of b, we replace the a plus d, okay. And third term c equal to a plus 2d. I hope you understand this. Next, x, y, z are three consecutive terms of GP. So, first term a equal to x instead of first term x, and y which is equal to x into r. You know that a comma ar comma ar square and so on. Instead of a, x is given. You just replace x. So, a equal to x and y is equal to x into that common ratio x r, and z is equal to x into r square, like a r square, so x r square, okay. So, now we are going to assign the value of y, z, similarly b and c, okay. So, now LHS. So, x power b minus c into y power c minus a into z power a minus b, okay. So x power, what is b? We have taken b is equal to a plus d. So a plus d minus, what is c? C is equal to a plus 2d into, instead of y, I am going to replace x r, okay. So x r power, what is c? A plus 2d minus a, okay, into z is equal to x r square, x r square whole power a minus b. A as it is, b is equal to a plus d, so a minus of a plus d. So, x power a plus d minus. So, if you multiply it by minus, what do we get? X power a plus d minus into plus minus, minus into plus minus, into here x r whole power, this plus a, this minus a will be cancelled. So, we will get 2d into this one x r square whole power, this plus a minus a will be cancelled, minus into plus minus d, okay. If we have same base, we can add their powers when we multiply them, so that here they have same base, x x x. So, and before this a will be cancelled. So, x power plus d minus 2d gives minus d into, this can be written as x power 2d into r power 2d into x r square. It means we can apply power's law. So r power 2 into minus d, or x power minus d first one, into r power 2 into minus d gives minus 2d, okay. Now x power, if we have same base x x x, so write it as x power minus d here plus 2d here minus d into r, here also r. So r power 2d minus 2d. So x power minus d gives minus 2d, minus 2d plus 2d gives 0, okay, into r power 2d minus 2d gives 0. You know that x power 0 is 1, as well as r power 0 is also 1. Therefore, 1 into 1, 1. Okay. It is RHS. And you know that anything power 0, any value power 0 is equal to 1. That concept I applied here. Okay. Therefore, RHS is equal to 1. Hence, it is proved. So, I hope you understand this concept. And next class, we'll see question number 10 and 11 in exercise 2.7. Okay. Thank you.